Hi guys, welcome to White Color Muscle, and today I'm with a judge from bodybuilding competition, Mr. Badal, and he is working for IT firm Microsoft, and besides that he has his passion for bodybuilding. He has won many competitions in Bangalore and Hyderabad as well. So hi Badal, nice to meet you here. And so can you please tell our viewers something about your life, something about your personal journey?
Well, if I talk about my personal journey, well, I have been into IT for like 14 years now, and well, passionate about bodybuilding and fitness for like around 8 years. I have been professionally doing it for like 6 years nonstop, and I have been my professional journey and my passion, I have always kept it in a, you know, different buckets so that I do not mix it up, and that's the reason why I'm you know, able to carry it so long.
So that's really nice and really inspiring for all the people watching out here, that he is continuing his passion into fitness industry, and alongside he is pursuing his career in the IT industry as well. So he's not like people always are dicey about what they should do.
That's right.
So he's balancing both the things nicely. So you should really go out and check out his Instagram and connect with him. You may get to learn a lot of things from him. So let's start with one question I have in mind, that recently you were a judge in Rage Classic, which happened last month in February, right?
Right.
So how was your experience over there?
Well, this was my first time on the other side of the table, and it was really a good experience to learn, as well as, you know, it feels different when you are actually judging the people when where you see you were there, you know, these many years. And, you know, it was great, and I feel that the competition itself was an example where, you know, I have been to so many competitions, and it was like, you know, the way they coordinated with each and every categories, you know, and the time frame that was set was really good. And we had good amount of participants as well.
Mm-hmm.
So, well, it was a good experience, and I think we'll be coming up soon with another competition for which will be at the national level, and I am excited about it as well.
Oh wow! So you mean that there's a another international Rage Classic coming up?
It will be at the national level.
It will be at the national level.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it will be maybe in the month of October, I guess.
Okay.
The dates are still not okay. Fixed, so it will be announced.
So guys, stay tuned to this channel, White Collar Muscle, for the dates of Rage Classic, which is going to happen somewhere around October 2019.
Yeah.
And it's a national level competition, so people from all over India can come and participate there. So something, what was different about Rage Classic event?
If we talk about the local competitions, and if we talk about the level that we showcased for Rage Classic, there's a lot of difference when it comes to, you know, there are very small things that matters a lot, how you respect the athletes backstage. You know, they should be you know, continuously informed about what's going on and when they should be ready. It should not be like hustle or hustle. You know that, hey, come on, get on the stage and it's your turn and all that stuff. But I like that thing, that it was different from the local competitions that happen here, and it was like international standards that I have been as well. It was really a good experience for all the athletes, I would say, and I would encourage all of you to get prepared for the coming competition and give your best, because we will be having all the categories that are of international standards. Like we'll be having men's physique. We'll be having classic physique. We'll be having bodybuilding open championship, and we'll also have a women's bikini and women's physique as well. So I really, really, you know, urge all the female athletes as well, to get prepared and you know, get in touch on the Rage Classic page, or get in touch with me directly. Any help regarding any questions regarding the posing or how it's gonna be, you are welcome to ask.
Great. So I'll mention his Instagram handle below and the Rage Classic Instagram as well below. So if you have any doubts how to prepare for the competition, or if you have any doubts about the journey of the competition and how is it gonna be, you can ask them, and it will be very helpful for you guys out there. So one more thing, so let's talk about the prize money for different categories. So what was that?
So the competition that recently happened, the prize money was equivalent to the prize money that we get at the national level stage, and it was just Mr. Bangalore. The prize money for the overall champion was 1 lakh, and for each group winner, so the first prize was 50,000, 30,000, and 20,000. So it was like first, second, third, and
wow.
I think it is a great amount for just competition which is just scoped at the Bangalore level. But if just imagine if we do it at the national level, what would be the prize money?
Wow, guys, wow. So right now it was in Bangalore at the
It was at a Bangalore level.
And still, the prize money was huge, guys. For each category, people got 50,000 and then
30 and 20.
So, and the overall category, the guy, how much
prize money was that? The overall championship for bodybuilding was 1 lakh.
That was 1 lakh, guys. So, this is just starting up. This was the first competition of Rage Classic, and next, more are upcoming. So if you wanna, you're passionate about bodybuilding and you wanna be respected, wanna be having great experience out there on the stage and backstage as well. So you should really participate in Rage Classic, upcoming Rage Classic.
Certainly.
Okay, great. So I think the people from Bangalore will have a upper hand, but the people are coming out from other states will also be, they'll have equivalent amount of respect, equivalent amount of, the comfort level for them.
What I feel, the way we treated the athletes, it was we even in Mr. Bangalore, we had athletes who came from outside, but there was nothing like, you know, the athletes from Bangalore had an upper hand, or the athletes from somewhere else had an upper hand. It was everyone was treated fair, and I believe that whatever decision was made in the men's physique and all the divisions, and we did had a tie as well.
Okay.
We didn't let anyone out. So when we saw that the physique was matching the other guy, we made sure we give a tie and we don't let the other guy
lose. Wow! Wow!
So this was an example of the sport that we are in, and a great sportsmanship as well. So I definitely believe that we would be good in the national level judging as well, and I just hope that it goes well as well.
Yeah. Best wishes from White Collar Muscle to Rage Classic. So one more question I have in my mind, like the upcoming bodybuilders. So how should they look forward to the upcoming competition in October? So how should their journey be? How should they plan it? Like how much amount of effort they should be putting in? Like what tips are there from your side?
So the athletes who want to prepare for the month of October, they got a handsome amount of 7 to 8 months. They can easily divide their prep into bulking and the cutting phase of the competition. And I guess you have a lot of time. And I would say if you don't have a good coach, go ahead and look for a good coach. If you are new in this field, don't just fall prey to any substances that are not required, and don't abuse anything. Just go ahead, call someone, get a good coach, get a good mentor, and don't go do those bro science thing. just don't screw yourself. I would just say that.
So two tips from Badal out here. First is time. You've got an ample amount of time, like 7 to 8 months. You have got to prepare, so you can bulk out and you can cut out. And the second thing what he mentioned is that a good mentor. So you should be looking at a good mentor who can give you a
good piece of good advice, rather putting you into a nutshell that when where you have to think that what I should do.
Okay, great. So he should be doing all the thinking, and then you should be just delivering what has to be done. Okay, great. That's really nice to hear. And some tips as a judge, what do you think, like a few mistakes people did, and if they don't do those mistakes, they would have ranked higher?
I had seen many people, they have a good physique, they have a good frame, but they cannot present it well. It's very important that you pose daily for last 2 months, pose daily for 20 minutes. It will help you to sharpen your muscles as well, because it will help you to hold the poses with a smile on your face, and not just you're just pumping it up and vibrating on the stage, like just shivering on the stage when you are hitting a pose. It shouldn't be like that. It should be a graceful, elegant pose, so that the person who is looking at you should feel that okay, this is the guy. because it, everything matters. It's not just the good body, it's the presentation as well, especially in classic physique and men's physique.
Okay, great, great. So any upcoming advice for the women categories, how's the race classic planning to get more women on board and take part in these competitions?
Obviously, we'll be having a lot of social media, advertising about the national competition. And what I have thought about it is, we should approach, because I am a part of a group where we have female athletes as well as male athletes as well. So since it's a national level competition, I can, send out a word that, okay, female athletes are most welcome, because in Mr. Bangalore, I just failed to mention this. We had good amount of money for the female athletes as well. We paid the same amount of money to the female athletes as well. It was 50, 30, and 20. But we had two participants for both the categories. So it was just 50 and 30,000 that was distributed. So
okay.
Just imagine, it's the same amount of money. It's so we believe in diversity anyways. So
yeah.
So I don't. We did not want to We wanted to make sure that female athletes are not left out.
Not left out.
They are balanced at the same level. Where we are giving the prize money for the male athletes. So this was really a good example again for all the associations out there where female athletes don't get a good amount of prize money
at par with the men.
Yes, that's right.
Okay. And one more thing. So Race Classic is affiliated to some bodybuilding association.
Yes, we recently got associated with the organization named IBBF.
IBBF.
And this is run by Mr. Kadam.
Okay.
And he's the president of that association. Don't get confused, because there are two IBBFs in India. But we are the ones who are associated with the association run by Mr. Kadam.
Mr. Kadam. So yeah. I'll put the link for IBBF in the description below, so you can check out there. So all the information will be given out there as well, so you can be updated with the website as well.
That's right. And we really urge the athletes to participate in this competition. Maybe it will open the doors for the international competitions in the coming months.
Oh, I really hope so. All the best for that. So looking forward to more Rage Classics in India and all over India. So all the best from White Column Muscle.
Thank you very
Rage
much.
Classic. And I just want to ask a few questions out of my personal interest. That what is your favorite food? Like, you like to eat, since you're a bodybuilder, you manage your IT profession, you manage your personal life, you manage your bodybuilding career. So how do you take food along with you?
So my favorite food is good old chicken.
Okay.
And yes, when I'm out, I'll go more on eating fish, because I can't prepare much of a fish at home. So I was just discussing with him that my wife is a vegetarian, I'm a non-vegetarian, so I have to balance that as well. So basically, I'll prepare chicken at home most of the times, and I'll carry my food when I'm going to the office. Amount of food I'll carry. So it's like a lifestyle.
So guys, you can also follow Badal by preparing your meals. You can pack them in some
containers
and take it to office and consume them instead of buying some chips and munching out on unhealthy food.
I won't say that you just eat chicken or fish or anything. You can eat anything. A balanced diet where you cook at home and carry it along with you, or order something where you find some healthy food. But not have those colas or those caffeine added drinks and stuff out when you are at the office. I would prefer to eat something healthy, but not unhealthy.
Okay, so that's the advice from Badal to all the IT professionals out there. And if you're an upcoming bodybuilder and you want to be a bodybuilder and you want to be on the stage, I must say Badal is the right guy. You must connect with him. And he has an amazing journey. Even he started as an IT professional, but now he's managing two careers at the same time. That's really, really motivational for people out there. So it was a really nice session with you.
Thank you very much.
And I look forward to seeing you at Rage Fitness.
Yes, sure.
You work out at Rage, right?
Yeah. So whenever I'm here, I'll work out here. Otherwise, okay. Mostly my practice goes on in my office itself.
Okay. Cool. So guys, I think that was really nice and informational session for you out there. If you like this video, please press the like icon and subscribe to the channel. White Collar Muscle.